Hello folks, my name is Mohammad Misbahuddin and I am the education provider of medical coding and I am teaching you about the certification called Certified Professional Coder. In this video, you will learn about integumentary system subsection, that is destructions most micrographic surgery. So let's start. For common type of skin cancers like basal cell carcinoma, squamous cell carcinoma or similar related skin cancers, the physician will perform this procedure. Basically, this procedure is developed by famous surgeon Patrick E. Moss. That's why this procedure is named as Moss micrographic surgery. In this procedure, the physician play two roles, one as a surgeon and as a pathologist. How the procedure happens? The physician will perform this procedure stage by stage on any anatomical site of body group. After removing the whole tumor or malignant lesion, the physician will excise the layer of the lesion. Then he will divide the tissue into blocks. After that, the physician will use microscope to determine whether the malignancy is present or not. If the malignancy is found, then the physician will take it to next stage and he will excise the layer again and examine it. This method is continued till the time the physician found negative reports. So for this procedure, the coder has to follow guidelines to code accurately. He has to identify anatomical site to which anatomical body group it belongs to. He has to also identify the stage. Here, each stage includes 5 tissue blocks. If the physician has divided the tissues more than 5 tissue blocks, then assign the code for each block. If the physician is performing repairs and grafts, then code it separately. Remember, do not code surgical pathological codes with Moss micrographic surgery because the physician is himself pathologist. Let's see CPT book for codes. For example, the patient present with 3 skin cancers, one on right neck, right hand and on left nose ala. So the physician prep draft and anesthetized the patient, then he removed the lesion of the neck and he divided into 2 tissue blocks. Then he found negative result under microscopic examination, and also same for the hand, but he divided the tissues into 3 blocks. And for the nose ala, he removed the tissue and divided the stage into 6 blocks, but he found the result positive. Again he took it to the second stage, divided the tissue into 2 blocks. Under microscopic examination, the margins are negative. So, for this kind of scenario, what codes you will assign? You need to remember the guidelines, identify anatomical site to which anatomical body group it belongs to, identify stage and code for each block. So, neck, hand and nose ala, these are in the same body group and belongs to one code, which is 17311. So you will assign 17311 3 times with modifier 59, but for 2 codes because the procedure performed on different sessions on different anatomical sites but on the same date. Then nose procedure took 2 stages, so you have to assign the add-on code 17312. Then remember, if the physician is dividing the tissue more than 5 tissue blocks, like 6 tissue blocks, then you have to assign 17315 for each block. So 17315 is to be coded for each block and also for all anatomical sites. Let's see CPT book for codes. So assign the code 17311 for the body group head, neck, hands, feet, genitalia or any location with surgery directly involving muscle, cartilage, bone, tendon, major nerves or vessels. You have to assign this code for first stage up to 5 tissue blocks. If the physician took the second stage, then you have to assign the add-on code 17312. So basically this is each additional stage after the first stage up to 5 tissue blocks. Then we have 17313, assign the code for the body group, trunk, arms or legs. So this is also first stage up to 5 tissue blocks. Then if the physician took this group to the next stage, then assign the add-on code 17314, and the final code we have 17315. This code is assigned for each block. Remember, this code is used for each block and applicable to all anatomical sites. And for any doubts or practicing questions, you can request me on cpctrainer@protonmail.com, and please don't forget to mention the section name. And thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like, share and comment.